Oh, I'm up on a beautiful little trail. Today, it's like, last week of February, 2020, on my Luna X1 with my new Peak drive gear, Peak plastic. Even though they call it a silent gear. Oops, this log's big enough to bash the motor. I'm not doing that. Oh, yep, there goes. Bash. I like jumping logs, but I don't like smashing the bottom of this X1 on logs, so I don't do it. This trail got a lot of rain recently, so it's a little gooey, so you can't really lean into the corners and nail them, but gear's pretty quiet. You're probably gonna hear more wind noise than gear right now. There's a big sinkhole up here. I've gotta go around, make sure it hasn't gotten bigger. Right there it is. Whoops. Yes. Ouch. The leaves have sucked up a lot of water, and so they're like damp sponges. And the trail is not really that solid right now. Boop, boop, boop. And that is just a little running stream right there. Yeah, I got one shoe too loose here. Reach down, grab the buckle here. Ratchet it up a little tighter here. There we go. Gooey here too. Right along the edge here. Pretty good drop off on my left right here. Gooey. Woo. Usually you can just lean over and rail them corners, but not today. It's not really a firm footing. Let me get up high here. This is a big mucky spring that comes out of the ground right there. Yeah, I'm feeling my tires slip out a little if I bend over and or lean over and try to get a big bite on the trail here. So, we'll just take the corners easy here. Easier. Now this one's got a nice bank, so we're good here, but these roots are just soaking wet. And it wants to throw you downhill like that. And downhill, you go down there, you have a hard time getting you and your bike back up it. All right, got a little left-hand turn downhill thing here. And a muck hole. I'm not into getting face full of black muck today, so we just take those as easy as we can. Lots of off-camera wet roots right here. Boom. Boom laka laka. Ooh, back end just slipped out. Those wet leaves. Bridge. Right hand turn. And a tight right here. The tree's in the way on your exit there, so that one you always have to like make sure you come out and get ready for the trees. This one you can usually rail right here. Whoops, I didn't. That was fast enough. Little bridge, and then a bridge up here that I can't ride because it has a nasty technical exit, and I'm not a trials rider. You have to come out and kind of yank your bike left real hard and jump up on a rock ledge. This is it right here. So come out jink, and don't go low. Get up high on those rocks, ride that groove out. Now there's young dudes around here that mad skills can do it. I ain't doing it. Don't have any desire. Here's the bike's being pushed in that line right now. Come out, you got a nice drop right there. And then a big root ball right here. And then I go down here, and get on right here. Yeah. Ouch. Yeah, these roots are definitely slippery. On the off camber angled ones there, my tires just start sliding down off of them. When it's dry, these Maxxis Minions get a really good bite, and they're better than the Maxxis Ardents I was running on my other bikes, which are a real good dry condition tire, but these Minions, I like them way better for the trails I have here. Face full of brush there. Boom. All right. All right, hang on. This is a pretty wild little drop right here. But since the log steps have rotted, it's gotten better because you don't have to clunk, clunk, clunk down off the log steps. Get off to this side, and if you come down too much speed, you can do some sliding on a day like today, but everything's so slick. Tree! All right. Well, that's a pretty much it for this section. I'm gonna go and do a different trail right after this one, and I'll film the climb on that because it's a really crazy climb. So check with me later.